Right, in the next few minutes, I'm going to show you how to create that that effect where it's going from sort of a pencil drawn or a hand drawn look to the actual video itself. It's really pretty easy to do in Adobe Premiere Elements, and that's what I'm using here. Your first idea might just be to go to the actual clip itself and start to add some effects to that that clip. But the way to do it, the way I like to do it, is have it go from one type of an effect to another. And the only way to do that is to have a copy of that clip. So let me go ahead and do that. Let me copy this to the clipboard. Go up here to say track two, and we'll just paste this. Control V, paste that right into place. Not the smoothest copy and paste in the world, but does the job. So now what I have is I have got video 3, which I can drag down to video 2. It doesn't really matter for what we're trying to do here, which is the same exact clip up on video 1. So all I really want is the video portion for video 2. So I'm going to right click and delete the audio. I don't need that. And then I'm going to go up to my Edit tab, go to my Effects, and I'm going to find my favorite effect. And for this one here, I'm just going to use the line drawing. You could probably try other things. The pixel one, the mosaic, I think they call it, is another interesting one to experiment around with. So just drag that line drawing effect right on top of your timeline. And I'll try to play this in real time, but my machine isn't the fastest with this video capturing software. But you get the idea that what's supposed to be happening is the rendering of that actual clip with this sort of line drawing effect applied to it. Now, if I weren't using my video capturing software, this would be playing in real time, but don't fret. It's just slow for the way I'm doing things here. So what we want to do is we want to have this effect sort of fade out into the actual real effect. So what I'm going to do is, if you highlight that clip, and you'll see it turn into that lighter blue color, you get this edit effects in the very lower portion of this edit section, and you also have the line drawing up at the very top there, that if you want to get rid of it, you highlight it or select it, and then over in the far right hand side, you get that little garbage can. You can delete it that way. So with the clip selected, just hit the edit effects button, and you get this little timeline. You may not have the timeline here. There's this little stopwatch here called high frames. This is probably what your interface is going to look like upon startup. Just toggle that little show keyframes, and you get this secondary window. This is the actual timeline of the selected clip. And because I only have one clip in my video, the timelines will actually match in terms of the duration. What this allows you to do is change the effects over time. So at this very beginning of the track, I might want the opacity to be, say, 100%. So just toggle this little stopwatch here, this toggle animation, and it adds that clip opacity at that point in time. Then maybe a couple seconds later, who knows what, I want that opacity to be, say, zero. So if I drag that clip opacity down to zero, it automatically adds that little key point or that time frame in for me. So what's going to happen from the very beginning of that clip, it goes from the opacity of video two, and it slowly applies that that line drawing, but it also fades it out, letting video one sort of take over. So the way these products operate is it renders from the top down. So it's going to render video 2, and then it's going to render video 1. And of course, it's going to render video 2. It's going to grab the whole video until it gets to where the opacity has been set to 0. There's nothing left for it to render, sort of where my cursor is. Then it will pick up video 1. Very, very slow transition there. Not my favorite. So I'm going to put my cursor somewhere around here and change that opacity back to, say, 100%, adds the keyframe. So what's going to happen is from the beginning of the clip to, I don't know, what is that, 14 seconds into it or something, then within just about a half a second, it goes from that line drawing to the actual video itself. So you can play around with this to speed this up or slow it down. A couple of tricks that you can do is you can move my cursor out of the way. You can select these little keyframes here and drag it around to wherever you want to change the when that setting happens in that point of time, or you can click and drag both of those keyframes and then move them sort of way out, you know, wherever you want. And of course you can move these things far apart to get a very slow transition, or I should say not a transition, a slow degradation in clip opacity where it goes from 100% down to nothing. Or you can make it very, very fast so it almost snaps into that. It depends on the effect that you're trying to get here. I really haven't found a good application for this, but the idea here is just how you can play around with some of these effects and get them to sort of disappear, bring the actual video. The trick here was using a copy of the video. The video 2 is actually a copy of video 1. It has to be the same exact copy, otherwise the videos just aren't going to line up. So when the opacity of the top one goes away, you want it to pick up kind of right where it left off. And the only way to do that is to have an exact copy of it. Well, that's all for this very short tutorial here. I hope you learned something. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to comment.